Hi, it's Vicky here for Limor Weber Designs. Today I will be creating the third page of my mixed media journal. If you have watched my previous videos on these two pages, you might know that I am creating a mixed media journal about flowers. So I will be creating the third page today using a lovely stamp by Penny Black, and I am also going to be using my gelatos to color everything. I will be using some colors from this lovely set, but I might also bring in some more colors that I get separately. So I am going to start up the page by applying some gesso, and that's because gelatos really blend nicely when you work on a gessoed surface. And that's where Ginger tried to taste gesso. And the gesso that I am using is nice and liquid, so it's very easy to apply, and it is by Faber-Castell. The journal that I'm working on is also by Faber-Castell, and it's one of their mini journals. I like that the pages are made out of thick chipboard, and they take mediums really well. I have picked up three different colors from my gelato set, and I will be applying them on my page. Remember that you do that only when gesso is totally dry. I am currently applying the first layer of color, and I will blend it with my finger, or you can blend it with a baby wipe. The baby wipes that I'm using are not very wet, or they will remove the color that I have already applied with my gelatos. So you can see that I have a nice and pale background, but you can build up the color as much as you like, as I am going to do. So you can see how vibrant you can get. I will keep adding more and more color and blending it with my finger. And you can see the colors that I am using on the screen at the moment. Gelatos are a very easy medium to use, and with a very vibrant and fun results. And it also reacts with water, which gives you a great opportunity for great techniques. And while I'm adding more and more color to the background until I'm happy with the blending, let me tell you that you can find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using just below the video in the details area, as well as on my blog. So now that I have finished applying color on my background, I am going to go ahead and stamp some script. So you can use any script stamp that you have on hand, and as you can see, I'm using two different archival inks, and I'm doing so because I want to have some variation of color on my background text. And I think that the script makes my background more interesting. And I can now go ahead and stamp my flowers on the page using black archival ink. I will try to position those flowers at the bottom of my page while taking care that no flower is going to stamp, or a leaf is going to stamp over those two holes that are on my page. So now that I'm happy with my placement, I am pressing hard, and I have a good impression of the flowers. Now, at this point, you can use any type of medium to color the flowers, but I chose to use my gelatos, and I am preparing this white cardstock with gesso, just because I plan to stamp the flowers again here, which I then going to use my gelatos to color them, blend them, and then cut them out. So the idea is to make a collage of those flowers, or a paper piecing piece of art. When gesso is dry, I stamp again using archival ink, and now I have a good impression of the flowers and the leaves. For coloring the leaves, I will be using a couple of shades of green, so I'm starting with a lighter one, and I am going to apply it on the leaves, and then I am going to add a slightly darker one only at the base of the leaves. I will blend everything with my fingers, and I will be using the exact same technique for the flowers, but using purple shades. Once I finish coloring, I am going to give it a good spray with water, which is going to make sure that all the colors are blended nicely together, as well as give it a more realistic look. Now everything is dry and I am using my scissors to cut out all the leaves and the flowers, and I am just placing them on my page. I haven't sticked down anything yet, but I just want to make sure that I know where everything is going. Before I stick everything down, I am going to add some splashes, and to do so I'm using a very thin brush and gesso. I have watered down gesso, so it's more liquid than it is, and I am adding a few splashes on my page. The bigger the brush you are using, the bigger the splashes that you are getting. I am going to leave this aside to dry, and you can see here a close-up look of how my background looks. So now I can go ahead and get ready to stick everything down. Just to make sure that I get rid of the white edge, I am using a black marker all over the edges. This is going to create the illusion that I have cut out the flowers very perfectly, but at the same time I get rid of the white edges. So now I'm using my gel medium, and I'm going to stick down both the flowers and the leaves. I am using a thin black marker, this is by Faber-Castell, to add back some of the details that I have lost after coloring the flowers. So I am adding the dots at the center of this flower, as well as some lines on the other flowers, which I can barely see just below the layers of gelato. And now with my white gel pen, I am going to add a few more details, and white highlights are something that I love doing on almost every art journal that I make. I think that they help my images pop against the background, and if you are finding your gel pen not working as properly as you would like, try to start it out on your finger like I'm doing here. So this is a close-up look, and I am going to add a few lines over the stems and blend them with my finger. This is not perfect at all, but at the same time it creates a nice and organic look. You can always use a marker, a green marker, to add some depth on the stems, but I decided to do all the coloring with gelatos today, so there you go. And now time to do some stenciling. I have a fresh jar of whipped sparkle. This is a product by Faber-Castell. It's nice and thick, and it's great for using it over stencils to create some dimensional details. Now this is a stencil by Tim Holtz, which is called Faded Dots. It is a stencil that I have been using again and again, and for sure this is not how your stencils should look like if you are neat and tidy and you wash them out whenever you use them. So we can all pretend that my stencil is nice and clean, and I will go ahead and add a few dimensional details, and I'm staying mainly at the edges of my page just to frame it. I am going to use this die cut. This is a die by Penny Black that says Inspire, which I have cut out of white cardstock, and I am going to stick it down using gel medium. At this stage you can always use your stamps to stamp a quote, or you can always use some alpha stickers to write down whatever you like, or even some printouts. There are endless possibilities on how you can journal. You can always use your black marker and write down whatever you like. And this is how my page turned out, and I am going to bring in the couple of other pages that I have already made so you can see all three of them together. And that was the page for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired, and if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of the page today. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel already, make sure to do so, because this is the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. If you want to see the videos of the other two pages from this mixed media journal that I have already shared on YouTube, you can click on any of the two videos on your screen. If you are watching from a mobile device, then you can find the links to those videos just below in the details area. Thank you all for watching.